1957 was a year of vision for the Tabernacle Baptist Church of Chicago. Reverend W. Orman Knight, seen here with his wife Margaret, was the pastor of Tabernacle Baptist and had led the church in its mission to win the lost and equip the saints. A time eventually came to expand the ministry and widen its mission, and the target was the developing western suburbs of Chicago. Members of Tabernacle Baptist were surveyed to see if a church plant in this area was within their grasp, and a resounding yes came through. On November 26, 1957, Pastor Knight, Lewis Collier, Charles Long, and others investigated buying a house in the western suburban area for $30,000. This was a lot of money for Tabernacle Baptist, and much prayer followed. On December 8th, a core group of 50 people from Tabernacle came out and surveyed the Lombard Villa Park area, going from house to house, inviting the neighbors to attend a service of the new church. They later met at Oliver Johnson's house at 602 North Westmore in Villa Park and told of their experiences in the neighborhood. The passage that was focused on was Psalms 107, verses 1 and 2. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. They also took a seed offering of $55.55, a far cry from the $30,000, trusting God would do a miracle. 3 days later came some bad news. The church couldn't afford to buy the house offered for $30,000. This caused some stress and disappointment and more trusting in God. However, on December 15th, the first official service of the brand new First Baptist Church got underway with a handful of locals still meeting in the small house at 602 North Westmore. Oliver Johnson felt a tug from the Lord and decided to purchase a house that the fledgling church could rent at cost. This house was at 512 North 2nd Street in Villa Park, and this became the new church home for the next year and a half. The first service at the 512 location was on December 22, 1957, and was a wonderful early Christmas present given by God to the new church and to the surrounding community. Tabernacle Baptist members and soon-to-be missionaries to Vietnam, Reverend and Mrs. Charles Long, were asked by Reverend Knight to shepherd the First Baptist Church. He gladly took to the task, and Reverend Knight also made appearances to preach in Villa Park, including a week-long series on Romans in early April in 1958, which solidified the core members of First Baptist. A baptism service was held on April 13th, and the church had 12 official members established. On April 20th, First Baptist Church of Villa Park was legally incorporated, and a public recognition service was held a week after, where 70 people attended, the largest gathering yet. During this time, Pastor Knight was getting ready to go into the mission field in the Philippines, and Reverend E.F. Partridge was candidating at Tabernacle Baptist Church. Pastor Partridge had a methodical ministry style and had a commitment to following through on various projects. Pastor Knight recommended him to be the new pastor for the church in Villa Park, and on May 4th, Pastor Partridge accepted the offer and the challenge. He started a Sunday school, a missionary program, and a building fund to one day get a new church structure in place of the house on 2nd Street. Judson Baptist Church in Oak Park donated $900 yearly towards First Baptist getting a new building, along with First Baptist of Downers Grove, who provided $500 yearly. Mrs. Fisher, a member at Tabernacle Baptist, had donated a good portion of land to her church. This land was sold by Tabernacle for $7,500, and all the proceeds went toward the building project. in August of 1958. This money bought two lots on the corner of Plymouth and Harvard for $5,000, and ground was broken on 518 North Harvard on September 14, 1958 for a parsonage church structure. Construction was completed and dedicated on May 17, 1959. The new structure had a small sanctuary, separate nursery, office space, kitchen, a basement for ministry, bedroom, and bathrooms. Ministry flourished and the church started to take shape. Community was developed among the people through socials, meals, and ministry. First Baptist started the Pioneer Girls Club, the Boys Brigade Club, hosted children's programs throughout the year. And also started a teen youth group. These groups were a big draw for those in the community and helped First Baptist to grow numerically. On January 20th, 1960, in a step of faith, five adjoining lots were purchased by First Baptist for $15,000 to eventually start building a new church to replace the parsonage, which was quickly running out of room. Practically all this money had to be borrowed. In October 1963, a new building program was initiated to create a new phase of ministry for First Baptist. A groundbreaking ceremony was hosted by Pastor Partridge early in the summer of 1964, which included a reading from Scripture and a prayer for direction in this new venture. Cornerstone was sealed in the fall of 1965, and the church building was finished shortly thereafter. first service of the new church building actually started in the parsonage. The whole assembly exited the old facility and entered the new facility to begin a time of worship that magnified God's faithfulness throughout the years. The church was officially dedicated on October 10, 1965, by Pastor Partridge, who was joined by the pastors of Judson Baptist, First Baptist of Elmhurst, and First Baptist of Downers Grove. Since then, First Baptist Church of Villa Park has been a lighthouse in the community. Keeping focused on our community, First Baptist has ministered to infants, children, adolescents, and adults of all ages. First Baptist has helped spread the gospel both locally and globally. Throughout the years, God has chosen to give our church a place in His eternal plans. Our church has been in different stages of change throughout the years. And owned the vision of different pastors throughout the years. Our past is one to be remembered and cherished, because out of the past comes a positive and connected future. Whatever new horizons the Lord has for First Baptist, we are confident that we are called to do all to the glory of God, and that God will glorify His own name in Villa Park and throughout the whole world. Amen.